Hey YouTube, how's it going? In today's video, I have the BMW E36 Vanos unit taken apart right in front of me, so I'm going to try to cram as many details as I can about the unit in one video, so stick around. So before I actually dig into the Vanos unit itself, I thought I'd stop by my old friends at Auto Engineering of Lexington, Massachusetts. They are a great group of guys and they're one of the best around when it comes to BMWs, Mercedes, Audis, and Volkswagens. I'll leave a link in the description below to their website. All right, so I got the Vanos units in this box right over here, and then there's this sandblaster unit that they've kindly let me use in their shop. So behind me in that room over there is their actual garage floor where they work on cars. I believe it's like 6 or 7 bays or so. So I'll do a shop tour later in the summer, mainly because they're doing a bunch of rearranging in the shop. But for now, let's get to the sandblasting. Alright guys, so I got both Vanos units right in front of me right here, one of which is the original one from my actual car, and it's only partially media blasted. If you guys want to see how I took apart this Vanos unit from my motor, please check out the video in the top right corner right here. I basically tear down the motor to the block in a 3-part video series, step-by-step details, and then all the hints and little pieces of advice that I could give you from my experience working on it. So the reason why I decided to blast this unit completely and take it apart is mainly because this is just like a spare unit that I have laying around in the garage. I wanted to clean it up the best I can so I can give you guys the most detail and the clearest representations of the parts of which I'm going to be talking about. I want to make it clear that you don't want to media blast the entire Vanos unit without taking it apart completely, mainly because, one, you don't want to damage the mating surfaces on the actual unit itself. You basically want to maintain the smoothest surface possible for all the mating surfaces so that it makes the best contact with the actual gasket when you reinstall this unit. So the very most, you could blast the outside so that it has a nice surface finish in the end, because there are parts that are hard to get to if you're trying to clean with a brush. The second reason why you don't want to media blast these units is to avoid contaminating the bearing surfaces inside the lubrication system and the actual bearing systems for the piston assembly inside the Vanos unit. As we all know, any sort of particulate contamination inside of a lubrication system is just a recipe for disaster. The best way to clean these parts would probably be taking them apart completely and throwing them into a hot tank, and then afterwards just taking care of little missed spots with like a wire brush or something. With all that being said about the BMW Single Vanos system, I'm gonna try my best and explain how every single little component works within the Vanos system itself, and then present all the potential problems you might face as the system ages, and how you can maintain and then fix those issues. So to start off, I want to talk about the actual Vanos housing itself first. So oil is supplied to the Vanos unit from the oil housing on the side of the motor. It comes up a rubber line and into this bolt right here. Now this bolt is hollow and has a couple holes on the side to allow for oil flow from the actual rubber line to go into the actual Vanos housing. So from there, there's an electronic solenoid that controls this actuator spring right here that directs the flow of oil through 3 different passages inside the housing itself. I've labeled the passages in red Sharpie right here just to give you guys an idea of the directions of oil flow in the Vanos system. So the next components I want to talk about is the piston and spline gear components right here. Now I've taken apart the Vanos unit because of the fact that it's easier to see how these components interact with each other once all the fasteners and bearings are removed. So as oil is directed in and out of this Vanos housing, it basically pushes on this piston right here so that it goes forward and back inside the Vanos unit. So this spline gear is actually connected to this piston so that as the piston moves in and out, so does the gear. This cap right here basically seals up the entire lubrication system to maintain the oil pressure as the piston moves in and out, basically isolating it away from the actual gear itself. So the next thing to talk about is how the actual spline gear is connected to the piston itself. You can see that the Torx bit used right here has a couple bearings and a couple washers in order to give the initial fastening of the spline gear to the piston. And then finally, to seal everything up, this nut is used along with this washer and bearing, and then this thicker washer right here, which I'll talk a little bit more about in just a sec. So if you take a closer look at the outer surface of the spline gear, you'll notice that the outer teeth of the spline gear mate to an outer gear that rotates along with the intake camshaft in unison with the exhaust camshaft. And now those two big gears are controlled by one timing chain. So the inner teeth of the spline actually mate to the intake camshaft physically. Because this gear is of helical design and has slanted teeth that are opposing in different directions, as this gear pushes in and out, it actually physically rotates the intake camshaft independently of those two larger cam gears that are already timed in unison. BMW came up with the double VANOS system later to provide independent control over the exhaust camshaft advancements as well. So one of the first mechanical symptoms you might experience with your E36 as it gets older is power and torque loss. So a probable cause of the potential power losses experienced on an older E36 is from this actual seal around this small piston inside the VANOS unit. So over time, this seal loses its elasticity and becomes brittle and can actually crack. The oil that leaks past this seal compromises the functionality of the unit as a whole. Now, Bison Systems is a great resource for seal repair kits for both single and double VANOS. The seals they provide are direct OEM replacements, and they are actually redesigned for better longevity. The next problem experienced is called VANOS rattle. Now, if you notice, this spline gear can move side to side very slightly, or like in a circle. Basically, that's called radial movement. Now, a little bit of radial play is normal. However, what's not normal is axial play. And by axial play, I mean in and out. So if you pull slightly up and down on the shaft, or if you wiggle it side to side, you can physically see that this gear actually tilts on its own axis. You can clearly see over here that the bearings actually wear down this washer over time. And then you can see the same behavior exhibited onto this washer right here. Now, to fix this issue, there's typically a redesign required for this bearing right here, and Bison System also provides that with this repair kit right here. So the kit actually comes with a replacement washer that is actually resized to decrease the gaps and all the wear points inside the system itself. Before you take apart the VANOS unit, you are going to need a couple specialty tools, the first of which is a modified 18mm socket right here. This socket is essentially a standard 18mm socket, but it's just flattened out and ground down so that it can mate properly to the low profile bolt on the actual piston of the VANOS unit. The next thing you're going to need is an actual vise to clamp down the actual piston assembly of the VANOS unit. You're going to need either rubber inserts from Bison Systems. You can also just use small pieces of wood that are flat in order to just safely grip around the piece without applying too much pressure. The last thing you're going to need is a pick in order to take out the old seal and to pick out any sort of thin washers inside the piston system itself. So moving on from those crazy details about the VANOS unit, time to take apart this one right here and perform the respective maintenance procedures from Bison Systems using their repair kits as well. I'll leave a link in the description to those procedures and the parts that I've used in this video. So now that everything is apart, I just want to quickly acknowledge some specific points and details on their website in order to install these new rings correctly and that new washer as well. Before installing this ring, you can put it in dry. I would actually just put a little bit of assembly lube around the outside just so that it snugs up inside the groove over here a lot better. In addition to that, this outer Teflon seal might need to be soaked in some warm water for about 2 minutes and dried before actually trying to stretch it around this gasket right here, mainly because it is a little bit stiffer. It's not really meant to stretch too much. It's more like an actual ring to a piston than it is to an actual like oil seal, for example. The next point revolves around this new washer right here. Now, if you look on their website, there's a very detailed procedure on how to actually test whether or not this is sized correctly. Basically, you have to install this back inside the piston, and once it's installed, you actually kind of have to test for play again. And depending on the type of play you still experience, they actually demonstrate a procedure of actually taking this washer, putting a piece of sandpaper, and actually sanding it down very, very slightly in order to make all the tolerances correct when refitting this new washer. And then to further demonstrate the differences between the washer, I thought I'd just measure them up with a basic caliper setup. As you can see, the measurement right there for the new washer is as such, and I'm actually going to measure up the old washer right now. So you can see that the new washer itself is actually about, give or so, 10 thousandths of an inch thinner than the stock one. So if you work at a machine shop or you have access to a machine shop, technically you could shave down the old washer itself, but it's just as cost effective to just purchase this yourself. All right, so everything is put back together, and I did put a little bit of lubrication in the bearings, and if you guys can see right here, the play is pretty much minimal now. Like, I can't shake it, I can't tilt it anymore, and actual play is eliminated here. You can still hear that there is side-to-side movement, which is normal, but as you can see, there is now no more tilting on the axis, and as well, the actual play itself is gone. There's another company called Dr. Vanos that actually refurbishes Vanos units. Their remanufactured units are pretty competitively priced, and they also feature improvements like modified oil passageways and in various internal component improvements to give you guys a Vanos unit that is better than stock. But if you're confident enough to tackle one of these projects yourself, it's fairly easy to do, minus the tedious aspects where you possibly have to take this piston apart again just to grind down that washer enough so that you have the correct tolerances to reduce play. So now that everything seems to be okay with the play in the system, and it seems like I don't have to do much retolerancing at all, I'm gonna go ahead and take apart the bolt again so that I torque everything down to the correct specifications and then proceed with the seal. All right, so I got ignition tube right behind me. He's panning his brake calipers right here. You can barely see them, but check out his... What's that?
I'm trying to block them. This is top secret.
So check out the video that I'll put up in the right-hand corner if you guys are interested to see how these brakes came out. So again, I don't know if you guys saw that I pointed it out, but don't forget to put this cap on before you tighten everything up. But essentially now, if you listen carefully, there's no play there, but you can still move this radially just to spec, but there's no play at all, and it can still spin nice and smooth. And if we compare it to this old unit right here with no modifications, you can clearly see how much of a difference that made. And if you want to test the seal, you can clearly hear the piston come in and out very nicely, very smoothly. But if you compare it to this one, you can feel that it pretty much just falls in on itself, meaning that the seal is compromised. All right, guys, so I hope you guys enjoyed this video of me trying my best to explain every single detail that I know about for these BMW Vanos units, or single Vanos units, rather. Again, if you guys are interested, I'll leave a link in the description for all the resources that I use in order to make this repair, and any other links that are relevant to this if you're not looking to service one of these yourself, but rather buy an actual refurbished unit from Dr. Vanos, for example. So if you guys like the content of this video, please hit that like button, and if you're new to the channel, please subscribe. If I missed any content about the Vanos units, or if there are any corrections that you guys would like to point out, please leave it as a comment below. I take any feedback that you guys give me very seriously, and I always want to produce better and better content for you guys. But regardless, I'll catch you guys in the next video, where I'll be doing more maintenance procedures on the E36, more mods, and in a bunch of work on other cars. So have a nice day, guys.